Getting the right tension on a bandsaw blade is important to maximize the life of the blade while getting the straightest cuts possible. But actually dialing in the right tension is not so easy. The gauges that come with the saws are not at all accurate, so there are a whole lot of tension setting techniques that people have worked up and are floating around on the internet. One of those techniques is tensioning the bandsaw blade so that when it is plucked, it plays a particular musical note. Now, I've always been able to get passable performance out of my bandsaw, but I thought I might benefit from really dialing in the tension, so I decided to give this musical note technique a try. And while I was at it, I figured I'd try to improve on it a bit, make it more accessible, and then share that process with all of you. But when I poked my head into this rabbit hole, it was a whole lot deeper than I initially thought it would be. I thought the only thing I would need to change the target note based on would be the distance between the two bandsaw wheels, but it started to seem pretty clear that the size and type of the blade also affected the note to tension relationship. I also kept running into the question of, what is the true tension on this blade? How can I get a measurement I can trust? If I had that, I could compare it to frequency of vibration and start to get a handle on this thing. I thought this $300 tensioning gauge would be the answer, but the more I played around with it, the more I started to not really trust its readings either. I think it's pretty good, but it's imperfect, and if I used its readings to guide my musical note process, all of those imperfections would be baked into the process I was recommending. So here's where the project ballooned. I was no longer refining and improving on a process to tension a blade to a musical note. I was going to build a phone app with inputs for all the bandsaw and blade characteristics that are relevant to the vibration frequency to tension relationship. The app would then use the phone's microphone to determine the fundamental frequency of vibration of the blade, convert it to a tension, and compare that to the ideal tension so the user could make corrections. So, lawyers were hired to write liability disclaimers, insurance policies were purchased, and app developers were commissioned to code this thing for both Android and iPhones. And I built the apparatus that has been coming together throughout this video. It is the answer to how can I get a tension measurement I can trust. This thing anchors a length of bandsaw blade to a strong wooden post on one end and a digital scale on the other. So as I tighten down on the blade, I can know very precisely what the tension the blade is actually experiencing is. I can then measure a corresponding frequency of vibration for that blade, and if I do this for a range of tensions, I can fit a correlation to convert any frequency into a tension. And if I do that process for a whole lot of different bandsaw blades, I can sort out what blade parameters are important and how do they affect the frequency to tension correlation and account for them in the app. So that's all done. Let's take a look at how it works. After opening the app, first click Edit Parameters to put in the specifics for your blade and saw. First, select your manufacturer. This really doesn't have much of an effect on the target frequency, so if your blade wasn't made by the two companies I tested enough to build specific correlations for, then there's a pretty minimal loss of accuracy when you select Other. Also, I'll improve and add manufacturers in the future, and people who buy now will get those upgrades for free. Okay, so next, input the wheel-to-wheel center distance in inches. Metric is also on the list for future improvements. Select whether or not the blade is carbide tipped and the material you're cutting, and the blade width in inches. Now click Done. If you just click back, it won't save your parameters. Also on the list for future upgrades. And you're ready to go. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to be plucking the blade on the back side of the saw. If you're setting up a blade and the guides aren't touching it, you can do this on the front. So I press Start and I get a countdown, and then I have a little metronome passing a green center 10 times, and I pluck the bandsaw blade every time the ball crosses that center. So the app gets 10 good readings, which made it easier to get a good reading. And you see right here, pretty good, but my blade's a little tight. Now I'm going to purposefully overcorrect and try this again. So I press Start, and again I get my countdown, and the metronome starts, and I pluck the blade each time that it crosses the center. If you miss one or two of them, that's okay. The system is looking at the average, so if it has a couple bad readings, it'll just throw them out and still give you a reading. Okay, so now I'm definitely too loose. Now I'm going to try to set it up to be perfect. And I have my furnace going in the background. This is kind of worst case for background noise. So what you're going to see here is twice the app is going to fail to get a good reading, and you're going to see the error message. So I finish up and it says measurement failure, try to reduce background noise. Now this is going to happen again. Getting this right was tricky, getting a good fundamental frequency reading and being confident in it. There's a balance between, do I set the app up to maybe give an erroneous reading, or maybe give too many of these failures? I've got it set fairly conservatively so that if it gives you a reading, I'm quite confident that it's a good reading, but that does mean you'll get some of these failures occasionally, which are kind of irritating, you know, just the way it is. I think it can be improved on in the future. It's not too bad, you know, even with that furnace background noise, still 3 out of 5 were good readings, and that's pretty representative of the performance. So for now, it's a $6 one-time purchase, and you'll automatically get any upgrades and improvements I make to this forever. After I put more money into improving the app, the price will go up. So if you think this is for you, now's the time to pick it up. Thanks for watching.